The operator of the damaged Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant says nuclear fuel may have melted down at the number 2 and number 3 reactors within days of the March 11th earthquake. But Tokyo Electric Power Company says both reactors are now stable with temperatures relatively low.
Brings me to my final question. Who are we trying to sell this to? Answer, we are trying to sell this to the archetypal average housewife, she who fills her basket.
On the basis of this assumption, it says most of the fuel would have melted down and reached the bottom of the reactor by 8 p.m. on March 15th.
They're incurable, all of them. I know that, and so does everybody else, until they get one. Then the rules suddenly change. With a boil on the nose, there's a sudden overnight surge in faith. They want to believe something will work.
That's about 101 hours after the earthquake. At the number 3 reactor, TEPCO says water levels began to plunge on March 13th. Again, if it's assumed that insufficient water was injected, the utility says the reactor fuel could have reached a state of meltdown at around 3 a.m. on March 14th. That's about 60 hours after the earthquake. However, TEPCO says that if the water gauges inside the two reactors were accurate, their readings show that there would have been sufficient levels of water in the pressure vessels. If this turns out to be true, the company says most of the nuclear fuel rods would be intact with limited damage.
Hello to all, we are the 24 May 2011. It is 11 a.m. in Japan. 1 hour ago, they announced that reactor number 2 and reactor number 3 have meltdown also. Not a big surprise for everybody, I think. Now they confirm meltdown of reactor number 2 and 3. They said that the meltdown at the unit 2 started 100 hours after the explosions, and number 3 start 60 hours after the explosions. So it starts just 2 days after the explosion at the power plant. A lot of us and a lot of scientists said it the first week, and so they confirm it today, 2 months after. You are gonna probably read it in a few hours. You know, it just went out here in Japan, so in few hours you are gonna have it officially in your news. So in fact now we can see that when fuel reactor start to melt, there is no partial meltdown. You really have to be extremely lucky to have just a partial meltdown, who is gonna stop to melt down when you are pouring water over the top. And the fact show that when it start to melt, it goes fully. So as I said in my last video, the situation at the power plant is totally hopeless. Whatever they will do later, you know, they are still talking about reinforcing the pool at attractor number 4, you know, building a tower, wall, extra building. They are still talking about doing that. They're talking about exchanging heat in reactor number 2, continuing to send water. I understand that they have to continue to work there, but I don't really understand where this operation will lead. As I said, to me the situation is totally hopeless. But you know, don't get me wrong, I understand that sometimes, you know, from videos it's difficult to understand exactly the meaning of everything that people say, everything that I say, especially that I make long videos. So I say many things, sometimes maybe some particular things are, you know, misunderstood, but I don't think the situation is hopeless for all Japan and Japanese. That's not what I say. I say the situation at Fukushima Daiichi is hopeless. I just mean they will not be able to handle it. Now we have three meltdowns and four reactor damage, three meltdowns. So it's for sure now an extremely bad nuclear disaster, because three meltdowns, there is no way this is a small scale level 7. In fact, this is three level 7 right now. And level 7 is just about you know, the release of radiation. When the power plant release radiation in the atmosphere, you know, a large amount, then they call it a level 7. So you see the bullshit of this level. I'm not sure that a full meltdown is included in a level 7, because they don't talk about meltdown. The nuclear industry, for them, meltdown doesn't exist. It should never happen. So it's not on the scale. We have three reactors, so three level 7 so far. It will make a level 21. And we are waiting for the last reactor. But even if we save, a way to speak. But let's say even if the last reactor doesn't melt down, would it make anybody happy? Would it make feel anybody successful? I don't think so. You know, three meltdown. Hey, how can it be worse? This is, you know, the simple questions that I ask to myself. How could it be worse, since they announced that the meltdown is the worst case scenario? Reactor number 3 contain the MOX fuel produced by Areva. The MOX fuel, full of plutonium, is the reactor number 3. This one also meltdown. So now, you know, we cannot even rely on the luck that the plutonium is in the pool, and so maybe it will stay there. No, the reactor number 3 is full of plutonium. The fuel rods are plutonium-based rods produced by Areva, as far as we know. So the three of them meltdown. Honestly, I don't want to predict anything for the future now, because, well, you can't now say something regarding the future and the consequences, the future consequences of these three meltdown. I mean, you cannot